the following Sunday, I'm like, yes, I ain't got to go Father's Day. I'm good. I'm okay with this. And so she's like, nope, you're this Sunday. And I was like, oh, God. Okay, all right. Jesus, yes. And so I told her yesterday, I shared with her. I said, you set me up because I'm a daddy's girl with father issues. And she was like, what? I was like, yeah, I got some bad issues. And you only mean to talk on Father's Day. And so I was sitting there and I was praying to the Holy Spirit. And I was like, okay, Holy Spirit, you're going to have to give me something to give the people to encourage them. And I was in the process of preparing for my lesson Thursday, preparing for the moment on Thursday. And God was like, I think Friday night we were in the midst of doing an encounter with the women and that we were doing forgiveness and things like that. And they were getting free, and the Holy Spirit was like, you need to share your daddy's story. How did you come from being a daddy's girl to having daddy issues to being back a daddy's girl? Mm. And I was like, I don't want to talk about that. Mm-hmm. That's my personal business, God. But God was like, there's somebody who needs that. So Father's Day is so emotional for me because I have friends who've lost fathers, and I was there when their fathers transitioned. And so every Father's Day, I have to sit there and think of great things to encourage them to get through the day. Let them know, okay, you're your dad's legacy, and your dad is still here. And, you know, Daddy God loves you. And one day I was encouraging a friend, and God was like, but you don't trust that even, you don't even trust that word. You don't trust the fact that I'm with you. You don't, you're telling your friends who are grieving on the loss of the earthly father that me, the heavenly father, is with you, but you don't even trust that word. So, how do you encourage them when you don't even trust the word? And I was like, well, Dad, I'm just doing my job. You know, just encourage the people, encourage the saints. Yeah, yeah. And, you know, I'm going through the motions because that's what I feel like I need to do. I'm a counselor. So, you know, as counselors, that's what we do. We encourage people. We help them through their transitions, their tribulations, whatever they're going through, their emotional issues. That's what we do. And so God was just like, no, I need you to get your dad issues together. And so I was like, okay, all right. So, with that being said, so today is emotional for me for the simple fact of a two-part that I have issues with my natural father. I love him, but it's some things that we're still working out. But I honor him, and God has given me to a place of forgiving him for things he didn't know of. So many times our earthly fathers do what their fathers taught them to do.
Right.
So it's a legacy of they taught me. This is how they responded. This is how I'm going to respond. Mm-hmm. So a lot of times we get caught up in the anger and the frustration of what they did, not knowing that that's what they were taught.
Right.
But then I had issues with Dad and God because I'm like, you don't care about me. You don't love me. But it was the issue of, but you don't trust me. And it goes back to what Pastor Trish was saying was, what's your faith account looking like in me as your name? So, what are fathers supposed to be? They're supposed to be compassionate, according to Psalms 103:13. Just as a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. They feel a sense of dependency, trust, and consistency in God. They are providers. They are disciplinaries. And they create legacies. In Proverbs 23:24, the father, the one who is right with God, will have much joy. He who has with a wise son will be glad in him. So I was like, okay, God, I know what fathers are supposed to be. And he was like, no, that's what I'm supposed to be with you. So do you see me in those areas? And I was like, you're a good provider. You're compassionate. You give me grace and mercy every day. And I depend on you. But that trust, sometimes you don't come through what I need you to. And you are definitely a disciplinary, and your legacy has lived for thousands upon thousands upon thousands of years. So you're good in some areas of my life. And God came back to Malachi 4:6, and this is the verse I always think about when people have daddy issues. It is, and he will turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, and the children the hearts of the children back to the father. And I was like, God, can I get there? So I went through like this crazy life change situation. I lost both my grandmothers got a divorce, moved back home. And I felt like God had left. I didn't see him as daddy. I saw him as this almighty judge and ruler because it seemed like he didn't love me anymore. And I was so devastated because I was like, but God, you said it. And you said it. And I was repeating that to him, his word. And the first thing he told me was, but darling, you don't see me as your dad. You see me as God when I'm trying to have an intimate relationship. So he brought me back to that scripture, Malachi 4:6. He said, I'm trying to win your heart. I don't need your worship. I don't need your praise. If I get your heart, I'll get all of that.
Yes.
And that's how God is. And we can capture God's heart. He'll give us the blessings. He'll give us the more than enough. He'll give us the love. He'll give us all that we need sincerely and abundantly. But we have to capture his heart.
Yes.
So many times we come into the house of God, we like, God, we're seeking your face. But have you saw his heart first?
Amen.
Have you saw what his heart looks like? So many times we're seeing God and we're like, God, I just won't. All that you said in your word, but even to get the things in his word, you have to capture his heart.
Yes, God.
You have to know his heart. So if you don't know that every morning you wake up and you breathe in and out that God doesn't love you, then you haven't got his heart yet. If you haven't looked to the left and right of you and you see graves and you see people at accidents and you just saw accident happen before you even got on the highway and it was like moments before you got, and you don't understand that that's the Father's heart towards you, you'll miss daddy.
Yeah.
And you will always see him as this judging God. So I had to come to the conclusion that I want my daddy. I don't want to be a daddy's girl anymore. And so on today, I just want to share with you how to become a daddy's girl or daddy's boy again. One, know his position. So Psalm 68:5 says, the father of the fatherless and protector of the widow is God in his holy habitation. God settles the solitary in a home. He leads out the prisoners to prosperity, but the rebellious dwell in parched lands. Simply put, he'll be whatever you need him to capture your heart. So all the brokenness that you feel every now and then, that you remember those things from your past, he is father enough to make you whole. And even with cracks in your heart, he can still seal it with his blood, with the blood of Jesus, and make you whole again. He is the true father. So I know this is hard when we have fallen in love with our earthly fathers, and our earthly fathers have been so great. And I have friends who lost their earthly fathers, and their fathers were the bomb.com. And I mean, even in my life, they were the bomb.com. They were great father figures. So when they left, it was like, oh my gosh, that's a father figure leaving me. And God had to bring to my remembrance this scripture. He said in Matthew 23:9, he says, and call no man your father on earth, but you only have one father.
God.
Who is in heaven.
Yes, God.
As hard as that was to accept, even here, our earthly fathers can become our gods. And God is saying, don't even call him father. Call him the assignment of father. He's not even father, he's the assignment of father. That means that I use him to represent me on earth, but it's not him that we should be worshiping. It's not him that we should be missing. We should always seek the Father, because he's the true and one and only Father. And so many times we get wrapped up in the man Father, that when that man Father is gone, we forget about the Heavenly Father, who's omnipresent, always there, and it's always waiting for us to seek him.
Yes, Lord. Come on now.
No, he is the confidence, protection, and strength giver. Proverbs 14:26, in the fear of the Lord, one has strength, confidence, and his children will find refuge. Even in my insecurities, my dad is securing me.
Yes.
Even in my own personal issues, even when I look in the mirror and I'm like, oh, not today, daddy says yes, because you are strong, you are courageous. You find refuge in me. I'm all you need for today. Even if you don't feel like it, I got you.
That's it.
Man, he is a God. Romans 8:14, for all who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. know how to call him. And because you are sons, daughters, God has sent the spirit of his son into our hearts. He's crying, Abba, Father. That means that we have the opportunity, because we receive Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, that even in our silent tears, even in our silent moments, our heart cries out to the Father, and he will answer, and he will respond, and he will hear our cry, even if we're not speaking it out of our mouth. Amen?
Yes.
Know his wisdom. Proverbs 4:11-13. I guide you in the way of wisdom and lead you along the straight path. When you walk, your steps will not be hampered. When you run, you will not stumble. Hold on to the instructions. Do not let it go. Guard it, for it is your life. Know how to receive his truth. Now, this was the hardest thing that I had to deal with. If any of you lack wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and will be given to him. So, this was hard. Because God is so great. He's such an awesome daddy. He would give us the desires of our heart. Not his heart, but our heart. No matter how much he knows it harm us. No matter, even though he knows the aftermath of when we receive it, what we have, he will still give it to us.
Yeah.
And that was the hardest thing. Because God had said to me, I gave it to you. That's what you asked for. You want to be married? Good. Got it. There you go. But you never asked for my heart. You never asked for a man that was seeking my heart. You never asked for anybody who's desiring me. Because if he desired me, then he'll find you without you even having to be looked upon. So that was hard. That's a hard truth. Knowing that God is saying to me that I'll give you your heart desires, but your heart got to match mine. And that's the truth. Last but not least, know your rights you have as a son or daughter of the Most High operating them. Acts 17:28-29. For in him we live and move and have our being. As even some of your own poets have said, for we are indeed his offspring. But being God's offspring, we ought not to think that the divine being is like gold or silver or stone, an image formed by the art and imagination of man. Simply put, don't put God in your mind.
That's right.
Allow him to operate beyond what you think, beyond how you see him, beyond how you feel like he should act as your daddy. Today, I challenge you as a daughter of the Most High, as a daddy's girl, I challenge you to stop seeing God as this all-powerful and get to know his heart and know that he's daddy in your life. Amen?
Amen.
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 Amen. God bless. That was a powerful word. Amen.